iPad letterers. In today's video, I'm going to review my favorite lettering apps for the iPad and Apple Pencil. I've started iPad lettering in 2015, and since then, I've tried out so many different apps, and so I thought I'd pick my favorite ones and show you their features. I will also tell you some of the pros and cons and why you might like to consider trying out these apps for yourself. You probably already know which app is going to come out on top, but you might be surprised about some of the other picks and also the reasons why I like them. The app that we are going to start with is Adobe Illustrator. This is a relatively new iPad app and therefore doesn't have too many features yet, but I really like it for lettering because it has vector brushes. So if you're struggling with getting your lettering pieces vectorized, you might like to consider using this app. What I really like the app is that it has a very intuitive user interface. It just feels really nice to use. It's not too overwhelming. And then it has these really nice pressure sensitive lettering brushes. They call them the blob brushes. And this is what they look like. There's not too many to choose from, but I really like using them. And you see, if I select my lettering piece now, and then I turn on the node tool, that we've got all these points now. So now it's really easy to adjust your lettering, and you can just move those nodes around and then adjust your lettering really nicely and easily. I also really like that blob brushes have a smoothing function. You can see that I've set the smoothness to 7 here. I think 7 or 8 are probably the best setting. If you set it all the way up to 10, then you can see that the smoothing is a little bit too keen and it doesn't really preserve your strokes anymore. So setting the smoothness to around 7 is giving really nice results. Another pro is that this app is free if you already have a Creative Cloud subscription, but this is actually also something that's bringing me to the cons right now, is that if you don't have a Creative Cloud subscription, then this app is really expensive. And then another thing I don't like so much is that there are not too many blob brushes to choose from, and you can also not add your own blob brushes. But other than that, Adobe Illustrator is a great app for lettering, especially if you want to vectorize your lettering, because it creates those vectors straight away and it supports pressure sensitivity with your Apple Pencil. Now, if you do have a Creative Cloud subscription, then you might also like to try their Adobe Fresco app. I don't like it quite as much as Illustrator for lettering, but it also has pressure sensitive brushes with that smoothing function. You can see here that Adobe Fresco actually has a larger selection of brushes. It has pixel brushes, and then it also has vector brushes similar to Adobe Illustrator, but I don't think they work quite as nicely as Adobe Illustrator. And you also can't export your artwork in vector format, so this kind of defeats that purpose a little bit. But I definitely recommend trying out this app, especially if you have a Creative Cloud subscription. Next up, we have that Paper by WeTransfer app. The reason why I'm showing you this app is because this is the first app that I've ever used for lettering, and this is the app I've used before I found Procreate. You can see some of my early lettering pieces. They were not that great, but this is what I used to do to practice my lettering before I had Procreate. Some of the pros of this app is that it's a free app, but it does have in-app purchase option. And then it has pressure sensitive brushes, and it's a super simple UI. It's really easy to learn and it's really easy to use. And then some of the cons with this app is that it's only got a limited number of brushes, and it also doesn't have streamlining. So creating smooth lettering pieces can be a little bit difficult. And then another thing that I don't like so much about this app is that you can't actually change any of the settings of these brushes. You can't even change the size of them. So this is pretty much all you have. And if you don't like this, then you're kind of stuck with it. But of course, this also makes it a little bit simpler because you don't have too many options. So you don't get overwhelmed easily. And that's why this app was really nice when I first started lettering. Now we're going to look at another vector app, and that is Affinity Designer. The big advantage of Affinity Designer over the Adobe apps is that it's a one-time purchase and not a subscription. Right at this time, you can actually get the app for a 50% discount at $9.99, which is a really good price for this app. It also has a lot more functionality than Illustrator, but is it any good for lettering? Let's find out. So with Affinity Designer, you can use the vector persona or the pixel persona. The pixel persona is very similar to Procreate, but let me show you the vector persona. It comes with a series of vector brushes. So let's select the vector brush tool. And then you'll see here on the other side, there is many, many different brushes to choose from. So this is definitely a big plus with Affinity Designer compared to the Adobe apps, because you have so many brushes to choose from. So I'm going to select one of my favorite brushes, and I'm just going to show you how this works. So let's do some lettering here. And so this is not too bad. So you can see that this has now created a path. But this is also one of the problems with this app. Adobe Illustrator creates shapes and not paths, which makes it much easier to change your letters, especially when it comes to that pressure sensitivity. Because this app has paths and not shapes, it's actually really difficult to change this. You could now go in and you could change the thickness of your stroke here, but this is very cumbersome and this is very hard to do. So I find lettering with Affinity Designer not so easy. And then it also has a lot of textured brushes, but they're actually almost impossible to use because they are pixel based behind the scenes. And then you lose the benefits of creating a vector in the first place. Next in my list is Artstudio Pro, and this is probably the app that is most comparable to Procreate, except it's more expensive and I don't like using it that much, especially not for lettering. I may be biased because I've been using Procreate for so long, but let me show you. One of the things that's really nice about this app is that it has a lot of different customizable brushes and probably more brush settings than Procreate. But a lot of brushes are not actually that nice, and I haven't been able to figure out how to make the smoothing feature work. I could have Googled it, of course, but in order to be comparable to Procreate, I think this should have been a lot more intuitive. I'm going to show you that watercolor letter brush here, and you can see it creates quite a nice effect. But the lack of that smoothing function really makes it quite hard to use this, and it's just not quite as enjoyable as using Procreate. All right, let's move on to the next option, and that is MediBang Paint. I know a lot of you have requested a tutorial for this app, and that's why I have downloaded it to try it out and to see if it's any good for lettering. It's a free app, which is super nice, but you'll see that it's full of ads. But once you are inside a canvas like I am here, it's not actually too bad. So let's check out some of the lettering features. Some of the pros of this app is that it has pressure sensitive brushes with smoothing, and you've also got the ability to adjust the brush settings, and it actually writes quite nicely, and I don't think this is too bad for a free app. And then some of the cons is that there are not too many brushes to choose from and also not too many customization options. And then of course my favorite app of all times is Procreate. It has by far the nicest user interface, the best selection of brushes with the ability to create your own brushes or purchase additional brushes. And it's by far the most precise app when it comes to translating the pressure of your Apple Pencil onto the canvas. If you can, I very much recommend you get the Procreate app. It's the gold standard for iPad lettering, and you won't get the same results with any of the other apps. The best vector-based app on the iPad is Adobe Illustrator. I really love the blob brush. And so if you're after an app that's really good for creating vector-based lettering pieces, then I definitely recommend Adobe Illustrator. All right, I really hope this video was useful showing you some of my favorite lettering apps. Let me know in the comments if you have other apps that you would like me to try out as well, and I'm more than happy to make another video. If you would like to find out more about Adobe Illustrator, I've actually got a tutorial where I'm showing you all the basics of Adobe Illustrator, and I'm going to put that up here. And likewise, if you would like to learn more about Procreate, I've also got a beginner tutorial, and I'm going to put this up here as well. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in my next video.